So what should we do our chemistry project on?
I don't know, but it's gotta be good.
I just wish we had some help. What is that wonderful smell?
I don't know, I think it's coming from the kitchen. Come on, let's check it out. What are you making? It smells delicious.
Perfecto! Chef Mario's making the chemistry! Cook, cook, eat, eat, huh!
What are you talking about?
Why, of course! Cooking is applied chemistry, and I am an expert. This year, there have been some delicious new discoveries. I can teach you about them. If you would like to help me prepare my main course, a pork tenderloin!
I'll start the oven.
Just make sure you turn on the gas before you light the match. But don't wait too long. That's how my cat died.
I don't think it's one of those kinds of ovens.
Stop! No! You silly girl! We cook pork in water baths these days. Studies show that this method takes less heat and reduces the amount of cooking loss.
What is going on?
Cooking in water reduces evaporation, so there is only a 1% weight loss. Regular cooking shows a 15% weight loss. Even steam cooking is less effective than a water bath.
Chef Mario, the water.
Please do not interrupt. Although steam has a higher enthalpy than water, cooking in the bath is more efficient because heat transfers better by the circulating water. This allows for the pork to be cooked faster and at a lower temperature.
Awesome! When will it be ready?
Just about now! It is ready.
But I thought you were making a pork tenderloin.
Sometimes all it takes is a little bit of wishing and just a drop of pixie dust.
Really?
Or would you prefer a frying pan upside the head? What a gullible child. Now to prepare the broccoli. I'm just going to do it the old-fashioned way.
Vegetables were healthier when they were raw. At least that's what my mom told me. She says they lose nutrients when you cook them.
Well, your mother is obviously not very bright. Other cooked veggies are bad. Not broccoli. Steam cooking releases the flavonoids from broccoli, which increase antioxidant activity. Duh. That should be about done.
I don't want to eat that. I don't even like broccoli.
Oh well, the other one and I will indulge in this healthful treat. Did you know that researchers at the University of California recently discovered that broccoli contains a chemical called, wait, Diindolylmethane.
Diindolylmethane?
Diindolylmethane. This chemical boosts immunity and fights bacteria. Now doesn't that sound just peachy?
Okay, fine, I'll eat it.
Good! Go out there and I will bring you your meal! This is what I was making earlier. It is my homemade cheese dip. Enjoy! Have you ever heard of typhoid Mary?
Not all chem is fun. Mary Malone was a cook who actually gave 53 people typhoid fever. Three of these people died. Do you want to do that? If you double dip, you can spread bacteria and disease. This year, a study showed that although cheese dip tends to be mildly acidic, which is usually unsuitable for microbial life, the proteins and lipids in the dip can act as a buffer and protects the bacteria. Double dipping leads to an increase in bacteria, which can be passed on. Be careful!
This is all very interesting, Chef Mario. You've had a great time today, but this doesn't seem like real chemistry. Where are all the beakers and test tubes? This is just cooking.
So this is the thanks I get? Fine. Cooking with those tools is rather ineffective, but I will give it a try.